everyone. Great to be talking to you on this episode. In this episode, we are going to talk about e-commerce platforms. Why do you really need an e-commerce platform? If you really think about it, I'll also tell you or share with you one of the mistakes we did at DC Cap, and later on we did fix it, but that was not so great then. Is we had a customer who really needed to get an e-commerce website running. And Magento was getting popular in those days. And we asked ourselves, you know, why should we choose Magento as a platform? Why can't we just build it? And that's exactly what we ended up doing. And we started writing custom code for e-commerce and trying to do the website for the customer. But looking back, that's not really the smartest thing to do. So let's ask this question. As a merchant, as a distributor, why do you need an e-commerce platform in the first place? Why can't you write custom code? The answer is very simple. When you go with an established e-commerce platform, you're not only getting the code, or you're not only getting the company, but you have an entire ecosystem of developers to support you. So you don't really depend on one particular agency to help you with your e-commerce websites. But then, let's say you do a custom code and a custom platform and you build it in-house, then you need to have a development team, or if there is an agency which is developing it for you, then you would need them to support it, and you kind of are hostage with them, and that's not a scenario you would want to be in. So typically, I mean, there are multiple e-commerce platforms like Magento, Shopify, BigCommerce, SAP Hybris, Salesforce Commerce, and if I were you and if I were a merchant, I would determine what is really good and what is important for my business and choose an e-commerce platform as opposed to going for a custom-built in-house e-commerce solution. I hope you liked it. Thank you.